Welcome to the series on Azure Migrate, your free migration and modernization platform, which helps you move workloads in a consistent and secure manner to Azure. In this video, we will cover the set of steps you need to go through prior to getting started with migrations to Azure. Before we dive into the product, let us look into what a typical cloud migration journey looks like. As you can see, it is divided into decide, plan, and execute. The decide phase of a cloud migration journey involves developing a business case, securing stakeholder buy-in, and selecting the appropriate cloud strategy to ensure alignment with the organization's goals. It also involves creating an inventory of various types of workloads and key applications running in the organization's data center to evaluate ROI and the cost savings of running them in cloud. The plan phase includes performing a detailed assessment of the current environment, choosing a migration strategy, creating a migration plan to ensure compliance, and preparing a landing zone for a smooth migration and business continuity. Finally, the execute phase involves implementing the migration plan by moving applications, data, and workloads to the cloud, while continuously monitoring performance and ensuring security and compliance. It also includes post-migration optimization, which is absolutely essential to fully leverage the benefits of cloud. Now that we understand the cloud migration journey of the customer, let us dive into how to get started with Azure Migrate by simply searching for the service in the Azure portal. We reach the landing page where it describes the different migration phases and prompts you to start by creating a project. Provide your subscription details. Your subscription in Azure is a container that holds a collection of connected business or technical resources which are used and billed as a group. Similarly, you can choose the resource group to create a project in, or choose to create a new resource group. A resource group in Azure is a logical container where you are creating your Azure resources. Name the project and select the desired region. Now, this project is basically a logical container of all the metadata that gets collected from your on-premises environment. For customers with data residency considerations, we've got you covered with this comprehensive region coverage. If you have a customer who has an organizational requirement to access Azure Migrate and other Azure resources without traversing public networks, the private endpoint project connectivity is for you. With this option, you can use the tool over a private network by using Azure Private Link. For today's demo, we'll stick to the default public endpoint connectivity scenario. So once you have defined the subscription, resource group, project name, and region, you can simply click on Create. Once the project is created, you can go to the All Projects page from the navigation pane. In this page, you can find all the Azure Migrate projects under different subscriptions. It is recommended, however, that you only create one single project for your entire data center. You can search for the project using its name and follow the link to the overview page. To begin discovering the on-premises IT environments in a unified manner, let's click on Start Discovery. With these two options, we can either discover using an appliance or using the custom import method. The custom import options include CSV file-based input, VMware inventory based on an rvtools.xlsx file, or SAP inventory using a .xlsx file input. You can download the import template, add the inventory data, and import the file. If you wish to get deeper insights, such as understanding the different software running in your servers, you can choose appliance-based discovery, and you can get started by choosing the virtualization. So, if you or your customer is running a VMware shop, whether a VMware environment or Hyper-V, or bare metal servers or servers running on other clouds which they'd like to discover and assess for the purpose of migrating them to Azure, you simply go ahead and choose the required scenario. Let's say we go with VMware. The first step here is to go ahead and give your appliance a name. And with that, what will happen is we'll ask the users to generate a key. So let's go ahead and give this a user-friendly name and call it Appliance 01. When you click on Generate Key, what it does is it creates some resources in the background and associates these resources to the Azure Migrate project. These resources are required for the functioning of Azure Migrate. At the same time, you'd see in the second step to go ahead and set up the appliance. The key that we created above would be required to register the appliance with this project. And thus, you now need to move to the next step, which is to set up the Azure Migrate appliance in one of two ways. Either download an OVA file, or you can also download a zip file. This zip file will contain a PowerShell installer script, and you can run that script on a dedicated server, which will then be enabled to perform Azure Migrate activities such as discovery, assessment, and migration. Now that you have learned how to create a project, in the next video, you will learn how to set up and discover your data center using the Azure Migrate appliance. You will also learn how to analyze your inventory and fix discovery issues before you build a business case to secure buy-in from your stakeholders. Thank you for watching this video.